Good morning and welcome to the TradeX Foods 3-Minute Market Insight. This is Robert Ryerson and here's the seafood news for Monday, October 20th, 2014. Chum salmon has been puzzling buyers all over the world this season as harvests have been far lower than anticipated, particularly in North America. As you may recall, the Alaskan total salmon harvest was 156.2 million fish, as reported by the Alaskan Department of Fisheries and Game. Of that total, 9.9 million chum salmon were caught, representing only 50% of the 19.8 million forecasted volume. Buyers typically use chum salmon as an economic substitute for sockeye, coho, and Atlantics in retail, for example. The recent shortages have put a lot of price pressure on this product, though, consequently driving up the market. In British Columbia, the Fraser River chum salmon estimates are based on the catch information from the Albion test fishery, which has been underway since September 1st. The estimated chum salmon run size as of last week is just over 1 million fish and could go as high as 1.3 million. The escapement goal is currently set at 800,000 fish. Current price points FOB sale for good meat color chums, H&G, are $2.35 a pound for 4 to 6s, $2.55 a pound for 6 9s, and $2.20 a pound for 9 ups. Pale meat color H&G chums are currently between $1.50 and $1.80 FOB Seattle. We are hearing that most chum is being sold on the fresh market. One processor expressed concerns last week that there might not be any frozen chum inventories. We will get a better picture of this situation once the Puget Sound fishery is further underway. Last week's test fishery in Washington found an average chum size at 10.4 pounds for the whole round. It's beginning to look a lot like the average size will pan out to be 6 to 9 pound H&G. Brights and GMCs. Pales, of course, show up at the end of the season. The chum salmon fishery opened in the Puget Sound last week, and it looks like it got off to a good start. One processor we spoke to told us the fish arrived a week earlier than anticipated, and that it's looking like 1.5 million fish might be caught. Further along in the Puget Sound fishery, we will have a better picture of the chum salmon outlook, and we will give you a more detailed update. Moving over to Asia, processors have been seeking large volumes of Hokkaido chums due to smaller catches than expected of chums in Alaska. As always, there's a strong demand in the Japanese domestic market for this product, and the high prices of salmon and trout are creating even more demand for the moderately priced chums. 120,000 tons of Hokkaido chums was caught in 2013, and 60% of that, or 68,000 tons, was shipped to the H&G market. In the past couple of years, Chinese processors have had difficulty importing Hokkaido chums as it is more expensive and very complicated to bring into China. As well, few buyers in the EU and in North America would accept the Hokkaido salmon due to radiation scares. Chinese plants were able to buy some Russian salmon last month. One packer purchased 300 tons of chum salmon from Russia and was told that there was another 3,000 tons that could be purchased if desired. Current market price is about $4,300 a metric ton China, leaving portion prices in the mid-threes. And now for a quick update on the cod market. The joint Russian-Norwegian Fisheries Commission met in Norway last week to agree on the 2015 total allowable catch. In 2013, the cod TAC was increased to 1 million tons, which was the largest on record. For the second consecutive year now, the TAC has decreased, and for 2015 it has been set at 894,000 tons. 45% will be for Norway, 55% will be for Russia. We are hearing that there is more frozen at sea fish available, and Chinese plants are able to offer cod products, but at much higher prices. Raw material is currently around 3,000 a metric ton China. This will set the end price for Pacific cod loins in the low threes. Speaking of cod, our recommended buy this week is IQF Alaskan production cod fillets, $2.45 a pound for 8/16, 10,000 pound minimum, FOB Seattle. Call your TradeX rep for more information. And for more great deals like this, please visit the recently launched TradeX Live, an online portal to our latest offerings of H&G and value-added seafood products. You can get seafood at your fingertips live and in real time. Ask your TradeX Foods representative to sign you up today. Tune in next week for a look at the halibut and black cod markets, as well as new labeling laws for products from China to the EU. Thank you for joining me for the TradeX Foods 3-Minute Market Insight. This is Robert Ryerson by Smart and Eat More Seafood.